Alright guys, Ivan here with another video, and this is gonna be just a little update video of the physiques that we can see today, and basically the post that these bodybuilders updated on their Instagram profiles mainly. The thing is, you know, bodybuilding is not happening on television or wherever, it's just happening on social media, and to be more precise, it's mostly Instagram and YouTube. So I just saw this post of Luke Sando and I was impressed, it looks just very good. He looks dry and shredded and ready. And I don't know about you guys, but I'm a huge fan of his. Why is that? I don't know. I just like these British guys. He has amazing personality, first of all. He's funny. He's a cool guy. But he has amazing physique. It's very thick. It's very developed. And, you know, he trains with heavyweights. So you can see the difference between these guys. He trains with heavyweights and he develops his physique the way it is supposed to look like. So it's very complete, very symmetric and everything, you know, it's just on point. I really like it, and I saw his story this of today, so you can see him posing here, and his coach, Chris Esito, is looking at him, and the funny thing, and he said that he's still watery, like really watery, and he still looks dry. I mean, in my opinion, this doesn't look very watery, but, you know, Chris said it, so he probably is. When he drops down that water, he's gonna look much drier, but he's definitely conditioned, he's definitely shredded, he lost all the fat that he can lose. Will he come absolutely dry? That's, you know, a big question for him, because he's not known for great conditioning. That was his weakness always, but he has amazing shape, amazing development of all the muscles, tight waist and everything. He just looks very, very good, and I expect him to come and to surprise us all. And yeah, you can see this picture here, also I said a funny guy. And then we can see a picture of Rafael Brandão, his post update. So you can see his physique, he's looking shredded, he looks ready, he looks more ready than Luke, as a matter of fact. But, you know, he doesn't have the size to compete with these guys, I think so. I mean, maybe he can make it up with his conditioning, you know, it's possible. So he definitely has conditioning, he definitely has the shape, everything is popping, everything looks perfect, so I'm very excited to see what he's gonna do. And also, yeah, you can see this post of his, so if you can see that he's dry, he's shredded, there is no fat, at least on his legs, pretty much nowhere else. He's known for great conditioning, and the thing about him, his amazing shape and overall flow of his physique is very beautiful, very aesthetic physique, aesthetically pleasing. So I think I'm gonna see him also do very, very well. As far as Rolly Winkler goes, I don't know, guys. I mean, I saw Dennis James talking about his physique, and he said that he doesn't look fat, he just looks watery. So if he can lose the water such a short time, he can, you know, come and maybe win. But I don't think that's gonna happen because of, you know, he looks just too watery. But you can see this picture here, his face is looking pretty much ready. You know, that's a good sign. So I hope he's gonna come, and I hope he's gonna win, because that's what I predicted in my first prediction video. Anyways, also Josh, you know, everybody's talking about Josh, and I was also thinking, before everything started, I was thinking that Josh is gonna do great. I was really excited about seeing him, but now as I'm analyzing these physiques more and more, I don't think he that just has the structure for it. Everything is possible, but his front double bicep, for example, doesn't look that impressive in my opinion, and also his back double bicep as well. I think he's gonna be just overwhelmed with Rolly Winkler and Brandon Currie and William Bonek. And yeah, there's a post of Brandon Currie here. You can see, you know, he's a beast. He's a huge guy. The only thing that I'm worried about as far as his physique goes, it's gonna be his legs from behind. So if he can fix that, but I don't think that can happen in only such a short time. He has amazing back, amazing V-taper, but, you know, his legs from behind just don't look, they don't match. And that's what Phil Heath said in his muscle development interview recently. You can check that out. Also, as far as classic physique goes, we're gonna see Wesley Vissers, who looks very, very good. I mean, he's not known for great conditioning. He is always in a great shape, he has an amazing structure, reminds us of Arnold Schwarzenegger himself very, very much. But he's not as shredded as these other guys. And here you can see that he looks very, very good. But I don't know, is it just the lighting or some filter or whatever? We're gonna see it on stage, but in my opinion, based on this this video and the post that I'm gonna see next, he definitely does look very, very shredded. So he can also do very good. I think he's gonna have a great placing. I think he's gonna definitely do a top 5. So we'll see. And what about Steve Laureus? I mean, he made his post long time ago and he said that's gonna be the last post of him. So we didn't really see much about, from him. I am expecting him to do well. And it's gonna be like questionable, you know, whether judges are gonna go for shape, for classic lines, or for sheer conditioning, and that's pretty much it, you know. Everybody's gonna try to hit the weight limit, so we're gonna see what happens. I hope Steve Laureus, you know, manages to put some crazy shreddedness and dryness. And yeah, you can see that George Peterson is not fooling around. He's looking peeled to the bone. He just looks shredded. But, you know, his physique is not very classic. He doesn't have those classic lines. But he's just the guy in the best shape. And it just depends on the judges, you know, whether they're going to reward conditioning and basically in whatever they reward in bodybuilding category, or are they going to just go for lines. And I don't think they can go for lines. What is the excuse? Like, this guy lost with perfect conditioning because he didn't have the lines, you know? That's too subjective, you know? Somebody can say, well, he looks classic. And somebody can say, no, he doesn't, you know? So for that reason, I think he's gonna win it, because look at these pictures, guys. This is just too shredded. I mean, I don't think there is many guys in the open or 212 that is shredded. He's just peeled, absolutely. He has probably insanely crazy good metabolism, because I see him posting cheat meals every few days. You know, he's eating hamburgers and fries, and he looks like this. It's just insane. So for that reason, I think he's gonna win this Arnold Classic physique category. And yeah, I wish him good luck, and I wish good luck to all the competitors. Hope they're gonna have fun, because I most certainly shall have fun by watching this Arnold Classic, because it's amazing. A lot of good competitors. If you enjoyed the video, guys, please like the video, and please leave me a comment down below. If you want to see more, subscribe. All the best. Bye-bye.